Can we gather everybody up? We get them together, and then they talk and they jibber jabber and do their thing, and then they give me a cue to call house lights. And then once that goes, house lights go, and they go on. And hopefully they don't come off during the show. Hey, if I could dig down deep in my heart, feelings will flood on my page. Would it satisfy your cheating heart? Would it help to ease my pain? Ease the pain. If I could wing, if I could sing a love song so divine. Hi, my name is Dale Opie Sherseth. I'm the production director for the Rolling Stones. What a production manager and director do is they put together a show from the start to the finish. We start creating what can and can't be done. Can the show fit into a venue? What type of venues are we playing? Even to the point of making sure people on the side see properly. All those things are done before the show even goes on sale. This is what I wanted to do throughout high school, is to be a roadie. I couldn't play any instruments, so I took on the challenge of being a roadie. My first real interaction with Mick was on stage. It was 1994. He said, you know, no need to ever lie to me, I've heard it all. I call it the Rolls Royce of touring. You have to listen to what they have to say and go by what they say, especially someone like Mick. And Keith and all of them, they tell you what they want. If they tell you they want it blue, they want it blue. You don't have to get fancy or anything like that, so you just go make it blue. There's always some kind of landmark show they want to do, something they want to make a statement with, and they like giving challenges, so it's always good.
This is the Rolling Stones' first visit to mainland China.
And the Chinese people finally have the opportunity to experience the world's greatest rock and roll band. This is truly an historic event.
This is always a great challenge for us to go to a new place. We're very, very excited to be here.
What we had to do was we had to go from stadium mode to a theater mode. So we went from 4 747s down to one of equipment. So there's a lot of thinking through things and making sure we know what we're bringing, because when you get there, there's pretty much you're not going to find anything else. Now you can get whatever you need there. It's a completely different world there. You don't need to bring every single thing there. They have video, they have lights, they have all this. At that time, they didn't. So we had to bring everything.
Okay, so, ready?
In Beijing, I heard this news. This kind of concert, come to China, to your home country, and you gotta see. I became a big fan of Rolling Stone because with the attitude of when they play music is just liberate on stage, you know, relax, enjoy your life, and be bad.
希望你们的到来。
Right before 2 or 3 days of the concert, I got invited to be a special guest and play with one song. It was like a dream. I remember I was on the train or on the plane to Shanghai, and I got the news. I even remember I had a talk, a short talk, one-minute talk with Mick Jagger. He said, "Are you the guy?" I said, "Yes, I'm." I said, "You can call me CJ."
Hey, how you doing? Nice to see you. Lovely to meet you. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
That's Ronnie. Yeah. Good job. We're going to do. That's Charlie.
He asked me to pick up a song, which one is easier for me. He was pretty nice. And okay, I said, Wild Horse.
And, cause Wild Horse is couldn't drag me away. Cause wild horses, we are riding someday.
Thank you very much.
This is the honor, it's a super honor. You know, this is, I was a very lucky guy to have this chance to share a stage with my hero.
Go.
We brought in the Honky Tonk Girls from back then. There are 2 giant inflatables that we had, one left, one right. We made these giant platforms up there. And they had to be redressed a little bit because they're a little, you know. They're Honky Tonk Girls. Going into China, you need to respect their culture. You have to respect what they do and how they act. You can't just come in and barge in and do this and that, because you don't want to be known as the ugly American that came in and caused all the trouble. And before they went on, they had to go through what songs they could play too. You know, a few days before, they got a list of songs they could not play.
This historically was the first time we had hot dog.
Brown sugar.
Brown sugar.
Is it really? Yeah. So we're doing Satisfaction and other familiar numbers.
He said to me, Beast of Berlin was on the list.
No, I don't think
it
was.
It spent the night together, was it?
Yeah,
it was. Was that one of them? That was the missing one.
You're allowed to bitch.
We can bitch all we want. We can.
That's it.
This one's called Bitch. Are you ready?
there was a great vibe. There was a great energy of the people there. They were happy to see us. You know, who wouldn't be happy to see the Rolling Stones in a small setting like that?
I learned a lot from that concert. Yeah. I watch all the details. You know, I really enjoy their playing. Even now, more than 80 years old. And I always think I can see my future. Maybe after 20 years, I will be on stage too. And I want to learn. I want to have this kind of life. This is my future.
One act that can carry it off wherever they play, and they put off what the setting is, from a club to a theater to an arena to a wide open field or an open beach like we did in Copacabana. They can pull it off. They know how to dance with every venue. Crying out loud, they've been around forever. The Beatles broke up, they didn't. At that time, I don't think anybody really knew who the Rolling Stones were in China either, which it always is a big step to put them in front to make some kind of mark. And look at now, China is flooded with shows. It's definitely an honor that we were able to do it at that time when it wasn't as easy to do as it is now. It was an exhilarating run. There were moments that were a bit of a blur. It was moving so fast. So the accomplishment of making it all happen is an honor.
I can watch their show, you know, all the time, anytime in China. I would love to watch it, to watch them again. You know, they still can, you know, blows our mind away. You know, I feel that, you know, anything can happen.